you've got Cranford blokes coming, eh? If there's nobody here, I'll recognise them.
They're all finished about. You don't know that.
There's a lot of them doing overtime. And they knock off.
Mind you, if we stay here long enough.
About 12 people waiting to see you.
Great. Get them.
That means we've got half the speakers in a shirt and tie. Unseen before.
That is good.
Afternoon.
Afternoon,
very, very you. Very well, I see Brian.
Well?
Yeah, not so bad, not so bad.
Biggest.
Afternoon, gentlemen. Do you remember this place? Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Well, I'm
not. Chicken dog would drown a picture of you. What's this gas?
It's rough, isn't it, being with students?
Before, that would probably have been 6 or 8 stages, I think.
Put that in one. I can't go down, that's a down. See how big that time that is? Got the exact profile. These are the smaller ones. You see the different sizes when we're coming to shut. These are some smaller ones. And these are just parking pieces that we knock out. And that's quite interesting. To machine that conventionally would take a day. So you can come down and listen. Last time we did the and if you've got to make a thing round, that's the big problem about making things go round the shaft. The thing we're going to make to go round is not going to be round, is it? When you cut it, you're going to have a gap. But eventually, this thing cuts so thinly and accurately, you can start off with a circle and end up with a circle. That might sound trivial, but if you imagine what we have to machine more than half and make them, it's a phenomenal thing. The efficiency of a turbine depends on the angle of the blade, I guess. Yeah. I don't know how accurate it is, so I'm not going to script it, but very, very accurate. And that's all it is. And we set it up. Leave it running, come back up and give it all the different. Then I'm sure you're right. All you've got is, you've got a sharp brass to make sure there's no grease on it. It's nice and clean. You put in the bead glass, take it out, mount it, set the probe down, leave it and walk away. So the job to get is setting it on the drop rope.
Paris on a spare part.
Run it, come down maybe.
Also alarms as well.
This is safe whilst not running. But usually, whilst running, this system can be used for keeping a general eye on whatever your diesel engine is doing. In this instance, it's set up for a ship. What it would show is the ship generator system, propulsion system, and power generation, all the conditions of your fuel tanks, water tanks, air starting system, etc. It can also show, over a period of time, it can show trend diagrams to give you an idea of what's happened over a period of time, i.e. if your power has dropped off or your efficiency has dropped down, this system will show you, although unfortunately it doesn't, it's not capable of doing anything about it, but there is another system available that can be used for that. If I may show you, on here we have this is a typical VS12G diesel engine, which could be used for main propulsion of a ship. Along here it shows cylinder temperatures of the exhausts, with 12 cylinders. You can see slight variations, 598 as opposed to 621. And obviously they're all within limits, but if one should go over the limit, an alarm will come up down the bottom here. And also you'll be able to track it down by looking at the screen. You've also got lube oil outlet temperature, jacket water outlet temperature, fuel oil leakage, oil mist, and lube oil pressure. Now your fuel oil leakage, if this should suddenly increase, it may indicate the fact that you have a burst fuel line, a pressure fuel line, and suddenly your fuel leakage would increase. Again, with the oil mist also, if you have a problem with the bearing inside your engine, it may increase the oil mist, and this would show up on here. With lube oil pressure from, say, a seal or a pipe should split, it would drop in that same sense. And it also gives you your power output kilowatts. Returning back to your local menu, we go to the fuel system, and it shows daily service tanks and conditions of your fuel systems as they're going. Returning again. Shows fuel tanks.
Just a moment, can we
yeah, no problem.
Well, you know,
tent in the desert.
Tent in the desert, yeah.
That was a good hotel.
Bayarwa was mine. I've only been to one, but Bayarwa, that was enough.
That's the split between diesel and turbine, because turbines tend to be a lot less trouble than diesels, because they're less moving parts.
So that's why we can't understand why everybody's going mad for 16 and 24 valve engines. We're actually trying to get down to one valve engine. Because there's less moving parts, less trouble. Everybody's in car engines now is going for huge numbers of valves, which is great when they're new. You wait until they go about a few miles on the clock and you start paying the bills to get them fixed. Then you'll find out why everybody went for simple engines. This is produced, it's probably 20 years ago, but that old pump smashed up car batteries. You know, when you take your old car batteries back, they just pulverise and recycle. With 4% liquid, which is probably sulfuric acid, that'll pump it. And we use it for pumping things like molasses, treacle, sugarcane molasses, which is almost solid. It's got 4% water, we can pump it. 4% liquid of any kind, we can pump it. And they just open vein, they just sit there and they just pump away for years.
Turbine, take it back up to almost new spec.
Yeah.
We haven't got a dent to suck it all out of the road. Good job. Do you think they can go? We've got a shot blast unit in there.
The main problem is working out the several.
These are basically totally flexible manufacturing systems for components of particular size. And they run from 4 units to 35,000 with this, which is in excess of 1 million. We've got a 5-axis motor, we've got a full machining sense on drive. So your cartridge or your pallet load, the components down this side. And it runs down and the machine, we go in the machine and the machine to the program. When it comes back out, we manually transfer them over. Because that machine is finishing the components off. The foundations on this cost 150,000 quid. If there's a nuclear bomb drops on Bedford, come and stand next to this, because this damn thing won't move. It's on about 10 foot of concrete, reinforced steel. So this will never move.
It's made by an amalgamation manufacturer.
Picked up both ends, the middle will stay. And it looks as though it'd be impossible. If you put a rope around that now and just run it down the shop a couple times and let it swing, you'll bend it. Big as it is. Only maybe 1.5-2 thou. That'll put all the bearings on. And you get abnormal bearing where you get no overheating. And in India they're really good, and in China as well, they just instead of getting them out of an engine, when you put a rope around and pull it out on a crane, and you put it on the back of a wagon and take it down a bumpy road, and when you say, well, it's twisted, they say, no, no, look at it, 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 it's twisted, it's just sitting there bouncing around. Because that's why you get the wear of them, because there is an element of life in the crank. These are CGF, post-grained forge cranks. They're conventional forge, how you get a really great hammer and you smack them into shape, right? And then to pull them off, what you do is you put a small, like an induction furnace, and you actually pull the sections out to give you the location on the machine. These things are actually made in one piece in a die. Just a single smack with a huge die.
I ain't got no problems off.
Here we go again. Let's do a rerun.
Are you ready then?
Badger on, yeah.
Okay, badger on.
Thanks very much. Yeah,
thanks very much.
Okay.
Reading, that's the one. Just go past the old store.
And the food was fantastic as well.
Right.
I think we'll have to do that once more. Thank you very much.
But you don't have to look.
Paul's done a
a wonderful picture of our past and our future, and yes, we are, our engines are getting bigger and more powerful, and we're lucky to be able to show you one of the bigger engines in our factory at the moment. And Dawn's done a superb picture here, if you can see it, but there's something here in the air flying, dragging along someone who's saying, "This one works, help." And then there's someone else down here, definitely very welcome in Allens, who's replying, "Well, what do you expect? It's made in Allens." These two, obviously, with the prizes, are excellent. A picture of the factory and a picture of a rotor being balanced on a dynamic balance machine. Great detail there, great detail. And finally, I'd just like to highlight the one that I think, if I was the only judge on these prizes, I'd definitely give it to Megan. She's drawn a picture of my office. And I'm not sure it's quite as comfortable as that. There's a lot more paper around than I see in that picture. But the best part about it is that she definitely promoted me, and I can see that I'm now managing director for that picture, which is not a title that I have at the moment. Well done, Megan. Right, Dory.
Right. Well, first one, this is in the young one. Young age group is it Aaron or Aaron Waterson?
Aaron. Can you just turn them around? Aaron.
Smile at Bruno, Aaron.
What's that? Oh, no.
Smile?
Good, lovely. Thank you. Good.
prizes are just consolation prizes for everybody who took part.
Right, here we go. Lovely, thank you.
Thank you.